Hey, welcome back to Rule the World. Now, it's been a long time since the last episode, I know. I'm really sorry about that, because I wanted to get these out about 3 a week. But unfortunately, I went on vacation, and that set us back quite a way. Don't worry, though, I'm back in the driver's seat, and we're ready to get rocking in Rule the World. So I've been refreshing my memory about where we were. Don't worry, though, I've caught back up to speed. I know pretty much where we were. Today, what we're going to be doing is mana turntables, which let you spread around mana and get it to different pools in different locations. That sounds a bit confusing, I know, but don't worry, I'll show you exactly what we mean in the episode when we build some. I'm also going to be looking at sparks today, and we're going to cover the agglomeration plate as well if we have time, get that built, so that next time when we come back, I should have a load of mana pools filled up to the brim, and we can just plow through Britannia in one quick episode. Now, I did some things before I went away on vacation, so let me walk you through those and show you what we've been up to, because it's all pretty cool, pretty exciting stuff. Right, okay, let's do it. I've got my cutlass, the dreaded Black Razor. I've also got my Bow of God Kings. I'll just bring that up onto the hotbar. Now, you guys mentioned that I can add regeneration to my Heart Piercer arrows, which means they never run out, and that'll be really handy because I'll be able to just carry around one stack instead of two. But I do have a whole load of stuff in my inventory, and I need a place to put it all. But I'll show you what I'm going to do about that in just a second. Now, we've got the mana pools over here. I moved them over from the place over here because it was getting a bit crowded over here, and I didn't like what we were doing here. What we were doing was we were just putting like a mana pool in front of the next one every time the other one filled up, and just let the mana spreader fill the new one up. And that was a really clunky way of doing it because it meant I could only fill up one mana pool at a time. So what I'm going to do this episode is investigate mana turntables. Now, what those turntables will do is, if I put one where I've broken the cobblestone here, and I put a mana spreader on top of it, it'll make that spreader spin around. And hopefully what that means is, the spreader will spin around and fill up any mana pools that I put along the edge of this platform. Now, that sounds too good to be true, so I'm waiting and bracing myself because we're probably going to run into a problem or two when we do it, but it's going to be pretty exciting to try that out, because I like the idea of just a spinning mana spreader. Sounds pretty cool. We're also going to be checking out sparks, which are a way to teleport mana from one place to another, so we can generate it over here, and then we can teleport it over to our kind of platform area over here, which is where we're going to do all of our crafting. I'm going to move the runic altar, which I've got in my pack now, I think. Remember, we did that to make the runes of water. I'm going to bring that over here so we can craft our runes over here on the crafting bit. I'm also going to put our agglomeration plate smack bam in the middle of this thing too. So it's going to be pretty cool. Now, what's this giant structure here, you say? Well, I'm glad you noticed it, guys, because this is the new warehouse that I've built for storing all of our Britannia stuff. And what I'll do is I'll start that process right now. Careful, don't want to get the whole place wet. I'll start that whole process now by plonking in some mana steel ingots and the lapis. Might as well put some sugarcane and bone meal in there. Ender pearls, yeah, why not? I'm probably going to use it to make some runes. I'll put the runes themselves in there. I'm going to put in all of the things that we're likely to need for Britannia. And the runic altar as well, yeah, now I know where it'll be. And the Lexica Botania as well. What's that? What a hold shift. Oh, 193rd edition, wow. Must be the patch version. I'll keep the Wand of the Forest on me though, because I might need that in future. And I'll just put some of these other bits and bobs over here in the chest. Now what we're going to do is we're going to transfer items. Oh, chicken, I'll need that to eat. Now what we're going to be doing is transferring some of the items that we don't need from over here into the Botania chest. Or rather the Britannia, oh that's grass, nice. Or rather the Britannia warehouse, and this is where we're going to store all of the things that we're likely to need for Britannia. I've got a whole bunch of crap in here as well, so it'll be nice to get it out of my pack and into this warehouse where we can just focus it all. And now just drag the mouse along like that. Oh yeah, super quick, super easy. I'll tell you what though, I'll leave the wood and the cobblestone here, or rather the stone, just because I use this over here to kind of turn into living wood and living rock. And there's no sense in making that even further away. But I can take the cables out of there now, and the dirt too. And might as well take the seeds as well. Right, so let's just do the last bit of filling up this warehouse. Right, there we are, good to go. Okay, so what are we going to do first? Oh man, I love the target reticule for the Bow of God Kings. It's pretty sweet. So what are we going to do first? We're going to set up the turntable and a whole bunch of mana pools. Now, refresh my memory, how do you make a mana pool? Do you have to have a diluted pool? No, I don't think you do. Or do you? Yeah, that's right. You make a diluted mana pool and you throw it into another mana pool. You throw it into diluted mana pool into diluted mana pool makes a mana pool. I think you actually... Can you throw it into a normal mana pool? I think we answered this question before, but I can't remember. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make as much living rock as I need to make a whole bunch of mana pools. But while I'm here, I might as well just get some of this living wood too, because I think you need this to make the turntable and the extra mana spreader that we're going to need for on top. All right, looking pretty good. So we're getting the wood there and the rock there. What I'm going to do now while that's charging up is make the turntable. Now, how do you make this thing and where is it? It looks kind of like an existing... There it is, the spreader turntable. It's got that same kind of brown color. And it needs a sticky piston right in the middle, and then it's living wood all around the edge. Okay, no worries. Sticky piston, just a normal piston, and some tar or slime or glue or raw rubber, actually. I think we have some of that lying around. And that's and the piston itself is just redstone iron, wooden planks, and cobblestone. Well, I'll go and make one of those while these things are turning into living wood and living rock. Now, while I'm out here, I've been away for 2 weeks, so let's just make sure the whole place is ticking over and nothing's exploded while I've been away. A good thing to check out, actually, I guess, is the old quarry. Oh, and look at this, the dream team themselves are chiseling away at the quarry. Let's see what they've been up to. Oh, man, we've got so much stuff now from the quarry. Look at this. Oh, yeah, inventory full of rare and precious booty. Mostly cobblestone, though, but yeah, it looks like it's digging away and they haven't missed anything. What's that over on the corner? Oh, that's like the frame. All right, this is looking pretty good. Before long, they'll have dug down all the way to the core, and I reckon I'm feeling lucky about this. I reckon we're going to get like 10 or 20 diamonds from this hole, from this quarry. So let's go and see what we've got in the... oh, there's Hannah, hard at work, bashing her hand crank. And I wonder how the ovens are doing. Anything in here? No, the furnaces are empty, but let's take a look at the food warehouse and see what's cooking in here. Whoa, yeah. Oh my god, almost 9,000 wheat, 5,000 seeds. Holy crap! Almost 6,000 raw salmon. Is that a 3 or an 8? I don't know. Could be an 8. Could be a 3. And we've got 8,000 raw fish. That's pretty good. But we've also got 8,000 cooked fish, 7,000 eggs, 4,300 puffer fish. That's more than we're ever likely to need. But it looks like the whole system is working and all of our meat and fish are being cooked. The fish especially. It looks like fish are the priority, which is why we've got so much of it. And let's double check, actually. Right, so we've got 67,000 of 30,000 food slots. Now, luckily for me, these warehouses are slightly bugged, and you can just keep adding stuff in. So I almost don't want to update the mod version because, well, I don't think you can, for one. But if I could, I might lose all the stuff I've got in there. Also, in here, we have 160,000 items of, well, 55,000 space. And let's see what we've got, like, in terms of iron ore. I bet we've got loads of iron ore. There's a block of redstone there. Well, we need redstone for the piston. So let's just get what we need first things first. There's some redstone. We'll need that. Iron ore. I wonder how much iron ore there is. Wow, we've got 1,100 tin ore. That's crazy. 688 iron ore. That is insane. But no iron bars. Where have I put those? 121 ender dust, and we can use that to make ender pearls. So that's a pretty good source of that. Whoa, a fireberry? Where did I get that from? Some gold ingots. Well, okay, let's focus on the things that I need first and foremost. And that is cobblestone. Whoa, 69,000 cobblestone? Oh my god, maybe I could turn this cobblestone into something like super amazing and indestructible. Deep iron ore? Wow. 900 copper? Oh man, I never need to go farming for copper ever again. So forget the red matter. Oh, I'll take out some of these mystical flowers as well, because we can use those in Britannia. Right, let's get a stack of this iron smelting away. Oh, 10 left, no worries. And while that's smelting, we can go and check on the living wood and the living rock. There we go, almost smelted, so I can get a few blocks of this out and I can start making the spreader turntable any second. There we go. Now, I'm not quite sure why iron is, it's like a silvery here, but in some mods, it's like a deep red. It's a bit weird. It looks like blood sometimes. Right, so we put iron there, cobblestone at the sides, redstone in the middle, and then wood planks along the top, and we should create... Oh, is that the wrong way around? There we go, a piston. Pretty sweet. Oh, I'll put these flowers in the warehouse just to get them out of the way. There we go. Right, so step two is putting slime and or rubber on the piston to make it into a sticky piston, and then we can turn that into a turntable. Right, we don't have any slime, but we do have a bunch of raw rubber, and I think that works as well. Fingers crossed, moment of truth. Blam, yes it does. Oh, sweet, that saved our bacon. Right, now let's go and make the turntable and the mana spreader to put on top of it. Right, now I'm thinking of making the next project like a Thormcraft project, because I've always loved Thormcraft, but I've never dove into it. Now, I want to make a suitable place for us to do Thormcraftery. So what I want you guys to do is, in the comments section, tell me what you think I should build the Thormcraft place of work to be. Do you want like a magical tower, like a dingy dark basement or a cave? Or maybe just like a plain old workbench? I don't know, or a shed? Whatever you think I should build my Thormcraft setup in, describe it as much as possible, maybe even draw a picture or something, and put it in the YouTube comments or on Reddit, and I'll see it, and I'll kind of get some ideas from you guys for how I'm going to build my Thormcraft zone in Rule the World, in the Kingdom of Stinterfell. Right, so I'm going to need some of this living wood, and I might need that mana spreader as well, and now let's go and make the mana turntable and the mana spreader on top of it. So I've got the mana spreader there. How do I make the turntable? That's an open crate. What does an open crate do? Oh, I don't know. There we go. A platform. What the hell? Elven gateway core. Oh, that must be for the gateway to Alfheim. So where is the turntable? There it is. The spreader turntable. Right. So this living wood all around a sticky piston. No sweat. Sweet. And now I've got the mana spreader to put on top of it. So this should be pretty open and shut. Let's go and try it. So if I put this down, and I put the mana spreader on top of it, there we go. Oh, right, it's spinning. Right, and if we get the wand out, we can see it shoot out. Oh, yeah, look at that. It's like some evil kind of nefarious laser of death. It's pretty cool. And what we can do is we can put mana pools all the way along these sides, and as the spreader's spinning, it'll slowly fill all of those up. And if we put down, I think we can probably fit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, well, 10, 11 if we put them here as well. We can fit that many mana pools, and that means if we just leave the server on overnight, tomorrow or whenever we come back to it, it's going to be full up with mana so we can get started even further. We can finish off Britannia with all the power of that mana. But before we do that, we're going to need a whole bunch of mana pools, which means I need to be putting down a lot more stone to turn into living rock. Okay, so how do you make a mana pool? Well, you have to make a mana pool out of a diluted mana pool, and you make a diluted mana pool with just a U-shape of living rock. So let's do that. Why am I in bed? Why did this happen? Oh, look, my chest has been replaced with a sleeping bag. There we go. That's kind of fixed it. Right, so let's just make one mana pool and try throwing this into the pools over here to see if it turns into a regular mana pool. Yeah, it does. Sweet. Let's go and make all of the mana pools that we need. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Plus that makes 7, so we're going to need at least 2 more. But these should turn into living rock any second. So let's just play the waiting game until they do. Oh, yeah, there it goes. It's turning. Now, it's quite cool because these turn exactly like about 60 seconds or something like that after you put them down. So they basically turn as you put them down. So you can see how quickly you put down the blocks. It's a bit of a nerdy thing, but you know, it's kind of cool. All right, pretty sweet. So we've got loads and loads of living rock now. That's pretty cool. Let's go and turn these into the last 2 mana pools that we need. So we should only need... There we go. 1, 2. Blam. 8 diluted mana pools. Let's turn all these into regular mana pools. Oh yeah, splish splash. Oh, I love that sound. Now, how are these mana pools doing for mana? Wow, they're still jam-packed full of mana. That's pretty sweet. Okay, the moment of truth. Let's put these mana pools down and see if they start filling up with mana. Blip, blip, blip. Blip, blip, blip. Blip, blip, blip. Oh, it's working. Oh, look at this. Machine gun mana spreading. Oh, that is amazing. Now, it's going to take a long time for some of these because it takes a long time for the mana spreader to fill up with mana. But this is slowly going to fill up all of these mana pools jam-packed with mana. That's really cool. All right, well, let's look at sparks. Now that we built those, let's take a look at sparks and see how they work. So first things first, how do you make a spark? Oh my god. So to make a spark, we're going to need blaze powder, a gold nugget, and white mana petals. Now, I don't think we have blaze powder, and I don't really want to go to the Nether. So how else can we make blaze powder? We can turn cinder pearls into blaze powder. We can turn fire bloom from the Erebus into blade powder. Blaze rods, we knew that one. Whoa, a crusher, but look at that thing. How big is that? Oh my god, I want to find out what that is. What mod is that from? Crusher. 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 Rock crusher. Standard railcraft. Multi-block. 3x2x2. Oh man, I want to make one of these, because if that's what it looks like in the end, that looks crazy. It's a shame we're not doing anything technical in this mod pack, because that looks freaking insane. I could use bees to make blaze powder. Blaze bees. Right, so blaze powder is a bit out of our reach, but what I'll do is, between this and next episode, I'll head into the Nether, kill some blazes, and see if I can get enough blaze rods to make us plenty of blaze powder. But what we can still do is make the agglomeration plate. Now, agglomeration plates are quite tricky to make. Where did I put my Encyclopedia Lexicon Britannia? Because that shows exactly how to do it. We're going to need the Runic Altar for sure. We're also going to need the Lexicon Britannia. We're going to need Mana Steel, I know. Let me just put some of this junk back in here. Might need Living Wood and Living Rock, so I might just hold on to those. Definitely need more Mana Steel than one stack, I think. We're going to need Lapis Lazuli blocks. We'll take out the blocks of Mana Steel, and we'll leave the rest of them here just in case. I mean, we can always come back if we need anything. So, the Lexica Botania, agglomeration plate. Right, it's set on top of a checkerboard pattern of Lapis Lazuli blocks and Living Rock. Mana would need to be provided to this block, and sparks would be the most effective way to do that. Well, it's a shame that we don't actually have those. And this is how you make one agglomeration plate. Now, creating the plate, this is how you create the plate. After the plate is set up and ready to receive mana, tossing a single mana steel ingot, a mana diamond, and a mana pearl on top of it will begin the infusion. Picking up any of the items will halt the infusion, causing severe mana loss. The infusion uses half of a mana pool. Wow, that's a lot of mana total to create a single piece of Terra Steel. Luckily enough, though, we've got nine different whatchamacallums creating mana. So we should have plenty enough to make the Terra Steel that we need. And what we can do is we can just move the spark around and reattune it so that it takes from each different mana pool, so we get maximum usage out of all of those pools. Multiple sparks would make it... Oh, no, we can set up multiple sparks to send all of the mana from those pools to the agglomeration plate. Oh, this is going to be pretty sick. Right, so this is the setup here. It's Living Rock in the corners, agglomeration plates in like a north, south, east, and west, and then in the middle, I guess, another Living Rock, and the agglomeration plate goes smack bam on top. We put a mana pearl, a mana steel ingot, and a mana diamond, all of those on top, and it creates one piece of Terra Steel. That's super simple. I can do that pretty much right away. Well, let's get straight to it. The only thing I'm missing from this is the sparks. That's going to be quite tricky to make. Now, how big is this platform? It's 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces of wood. Okay, so it's slightly irregular. It's going to look a little unneat, but that's fine. We can just put it in the corner here, and it won't look too bad. Right, there we go. So now we need Living Rock and Lapis Lazuli in a checkerboard pattern, with the Living Rock on the edges, and then Lapis Lazuli blocks all the way around the side. So this is the pattern that we need for the agglomeration plate. Now let's make the plate. And the plate is Lapis blocks, a block of Mana Steel, both of those simple, and we're going to need a few runes. This is where it gets tricky. Now I've got a rune of water, but I don't have these other runes, I don't think. Let me check. I know there was another rune in here. So I've got a rune of water. Did I see another rune somewhere? No, I guess not. I thought I made more than one type of rune. Well, I'll put the stuff that I don't need back in here. Like the mana steel ingots we can take care of for the time being. Don't need the lapis lazuli bits there. Don't even need the runic... Well, we will need the runic altar actually to create the runes themselves. So let's quickly create the runes that we need to make the agglomeration plate. So we have a rune of water. Next up, a rune of earth. Shift-click to see the recipe. We need stone. We need a block of coal, mushrooms, and 3 mana steel. No sweat. Oh, now we never did give the Bow of Kings to old Theron. In fact, you know, where are you, Theron? Oh man, it's raining. Well, it's raining for you 24/7, my friend, because your day is only about to get worse. That's right, we're gonna give you the best bow in creation. The Bow of Kings. Let's just remind ourselves how good this bow is. All right, look, all our dudes are hiding up in here, probably because there's not enough food. Well, it's okay, there doesn't need to be any food. Excuse me, or maybe it's because the door is broken. Some NPCs have trouble with doors, and I'm having serious troubles just getting in. I might just knock Chloe here out of the way. Excuse me, just coming through. Oh, man, she's really stuck in the door. Let's just break the door. There we go. Theron, my friend, I've come to upgrade your bow. I'll take that and throw it away. There you go. Oh, now he's holding the Bow of Kings. Oh, what's going on here? Ross, no, don't get stuck. Oh, man, he got stuck in the wall. All right, let's rename Theron OK Shot. We're going to upgrade him because he did well in the battle against the Hydra. So we're going to call him Theron Mediocre Shot. Mediocre shots. There we go. Very Mad Max. All right, let's get the hell out of Dodge. Oh, man, remember when we took down the Hydra? Or rather, remember when the army of Rosses, the army of Grunts, took down the Hydra? What a day. What a day to remember. Right, okay, so we have a mana spreader now, bound to this runic altar, and it's sucking from the mana pool. Now, if I right-click on the mana spreader, look, that's full of green. That means it's full of... full of mana. So that means it should be sucking mana from this mana pool, but just in case, we're also going to set these mana pools to spare mana to nearby items. Now that usually just works with things like my ring, but let's see if it works with the spreader as well, and let's start putting the things onto the runic altar. Oh, there we go! It's doing it! It's slowly starting now to create the rune. Right, so you put the living rock on top, and you use the Wand of the Forest. Again. Blam! Oh yeah, 3 runes of earth. Okay, let's get the rune factory working and get onto the next rune required for the agglomeration plate. Right, next up is a rune of mana. A mana pearl and loads of... Right, so I'll need to infuse an ender pearl with mana. There we go, 6 should be enough. And now I can throw this ender pearl. I might as well use these mini mana pools we've got going over here. This spread is working great. Yep, and there's enough mana in here for me to create these magical ender pearls. Now, we're going to need loads of these, so I might as well just use up enough mana. Right, and these are going to charge anyway over time. They've got like a small amount of mana in them. But don't worry, over time, if I leave this on overnight, all those pools should be 100% full. And hey presto, bam! Runes of... Wait, one? One rune of mana? What a rip! All right, let's make the next rune. Oh yeah, we're cooking with bacon now, cooking with gas, petrol, and uranium probably. We've got like a nuclear-fueled runic altar reaction. Almost ready. Now, how is this mana doing? Mana pool doing for mana? Wow, it's barely lost any at all. I could just use my ring and replenish this up to full from one of those pools over there. Blam! Got 3 out of that as well. Pretty good result. And now the final rune, the rune of fire. Oh god. Right, the nether brick. The piece of gunpowder. 1, 2, 3. Was it? Mana steels? And of course, the nether wart. Oh, that didn't quite land on the thing. There we go. Now, is this enough? No, this is the wrong recipe. What are we missing? 3 mana steel, nether brick, gunpowder, nether wart. Ah, we only got 2 mana steel on there. Okay.
Glam.
Oh, and this is the final rune. So we're going to get the agglomeration plate into place, and that means we can start making Terra Steel as soon as those mana pools over there are filled up and we have the sparks. Right, so this should be everything we need. All of the runes and all of the materials. Let's go to the crafting bench and make the agglomeration plate. Right, lapis across the top. Three of those. A mana steel block there, was it? And now, what is the rune setup? Well, let's do it in the order that we made it. We made the rune of water first, because we had it. Then there was the rune of earth. There was the rune of mana. There was the rune of fire at the end. And then there was the rune of air here. Bam! Oh, yeah! Terrestrial agglomeration plate. This is a momentous moment. Let's plot it down. Bam! And this should be all we need to start making... what is it? It's not Terra Steel, is it? Yeah, it is. It's Terra Steel. This awesome green... Let me show you it. Wait. Terra. There it is, this awesome green bar of metal. And using it, we can make all of these cool things. A Terra Blade, some Terra Steel armor, a Helmet of Revealing. 20% less mana cost on mana tools. Regen even if hunger isn't topped off. Armor set, Will of the Ancients. No way, maybe we should make a set of this because A, it looks a bit cooler than my Viro Ceres. I'm not sure what the protection's like. Protection 3. Protection 3. 6, 6, 5, and 4. 8. Protection 8! Wow, this is even more protective than the armor I've got. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a full set of Terra Steel chest plate. Because also what I think it does is it means the items that you have cost less mana to use. So it means when I start using my Ring of Flying, I'm not going to need... anywhere near the amount of mana that I would normally to get around. Oh man, that's pretty sweet. I almost want to make our first piece of Terra Steel, but I haven't got the sparks yet, so I can't send the mana this way. Actually, what I could do is I could just use the mana spreader, and if we only need, it's half a pool per Terra Steel ingot, so I can make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ingots with just this level of mana alone. But what I want to do is I also want to use sparks. So next episode, we're going to make some mana sparks to send all of the mana from our new pools that are generating mana over there. We're going to use this agglomeration plate. I don't know if it works yet because I haven't tested it, but this episode we definitely made it. So next episode I'm going to make as much Terra Steel as I possibly can with all of the mana that I've saved up. And I'm going to probably, my main focus definitely is a Ring of Flying, because then we can make a castle kind of thing to do our Thormcraft in. But we can also do it for all of our Let's Builds in Sjinterfell, but also as soon as we get the portal to Alfheim, we can go through and we can get that next piece of the goddess Renzovia. And the closer we get to her, the closer we get to ruling the world. So, alright guys, this is the part of the episode where I tell you to press like and subscribe. But I want to tell you why we ask you to press like. And that's because every time you press like, it promotes that video and makes more people see it. So if you want more people to see Rule the World, make sure you do hit like. Also, hit subscribe if you haven't done, if you want to see more of my stuff. And until next time, guys, take care.